Students, hello. You have a job each semester. Your task is to create a web page for each course you take at BMHS. And on that web page, you will discuss how you've grown as a student. You then have to upload documents or pictures or whatever evidence you have to support your claims of growth. So, to recap real quick, you're going to make one web page for each course. You're going to have one write-up on that web page about how you've grown in that course, about 2 to 3 paragraphs, and you're going to have to upload and create 2 pieces of evidence to support your claims of growth. In this video, we will tour the website and introduce you to the different sections of the site. Your student growth portfolio should be divided into 5 main sections: the home page, and then one page for each your freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior year. Here we are looking at the home page. The home page consists of a title and 3 text boxes. At the top of the page, you have your full name, capitalized correctly, and a subtitle of Bishop Montgomery High School -student portfolio. Also on the home page is a quote. Your quote is your choice, but make sure that you choose school appropriate material, as it will be seen by your teachers and possibly colleges. Below the home page quote, we have a student biography of about 3 paragraphs. Write about yourself. Where did you come from? What ambitions do you have as a student or in the future? What are your main focuses in life right now? Tell us about how you got to be a student at BMHS. It's your choice, but write about 3 paragraphs discussing your own personal story. Finally, at the bottom of the page is a student resume. Create a bolded list of your accomplishments and highlights. Include information about your name, hometown, hobbies. What abilities do you excel at? Do you have any work experience or volunteer experience? Consider this section to be a student resume. Let's look at a page used to represent a year of courses at BMHS. Each, the freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior pages follow the same format. So if you're working on another year, you can follow the same directions in the following videos. Again, this page consists of 3 text boxes. One for a quote for the year, one used to link your courses for the fall semester, and one for linking your courses to the spring semester. On each page representing a year of courses, you'll be creating hyperlinks to individual course pages. Let's look at an individual course page. Each other course page follows the same content and format. So in subsequent videos, you can follow the same directions. Each course page contains course information, your growth reflection, and 2 pieces of evidence. A course page begins with a header of course information. Include what period you took the course, who your teacher was, the term you took the course, and your overall grade. Write your actual grade. If it's low but improves in the future, feel free to change it, but don't inflate your grade to something you have not earned. Below the course information header, write your reflection of growth for the course. Remember, your goal is to discuss how you've grown as a student. This could be intellectually or emotionally. For example, if you started your course without the knowledge of how to capitalize correctly, for example, you might capitalize every word in a sentence, but now, as you've proceeded through the course, you're solid on the rules of grammar and punctuation, you could use that for your reflection. Or maybe when you started your math course, you did not know about the order of operations, but now you know the correct order for parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. Underneath your reflection, you need to provide 2 pieces of evidence to support your reflection of growth. The only evidence that you cannot use would be an examination or a quiz. If a teacher has given back an exam or quiz and you still have a copy or some other formal assessment, do not post it on your website. Otherwise, feel free to use homework, essays, worksheets, projects, or any other classwork to support your claim of evidence. In my previous examples, I could easily support my new ability to use grammar and punctuation with a writing sample demonstrating poor grammar and punctuation, and then a second piece of evidence showing my corrected use of grammar and punctuation. In my math class, I could show worksheets or homework where I incorrectly applied the order of operations, and then I could show a follow-up document showing the corrected use of the order of operations. Remember, your evidence needs to support your reflection of growth, and your evidence needs to show the growth you discuss. For each piece of evidence, include a title, the actual evidence, and a caption explaining the evidence being presented. So that's it, a front page for each year and a page for each course. Your reflection is just how you've gotten better as a student or a person, and all you need to do is upload work you've already completed. In the instructions video, we'll cover how to build the site. It's easier than you might think.